Hi, I'm Jack. Welcome to VapeCore. Today, we're going to have a look at the DotSquawk from DotMod, which is their mechanical squawking device, a little box shape. It is built to the same standards as all the other DotMod stuff, so you know you're going to be getting a really nice high-quality device. A few quick things about it. 12 ml bottle capacity, which is fantastic. Silicon bottle as well, so very easy to press and squonk your juice. Replaceable door covers, as well as the standard 24-karat gold plating on the 510 pin and fire button. So, let's dive down, have a look at the device up close. So here's everything taken apart, so you can see all the individual components. Two doors here, they are interchangeable. So if you decided you wanted different colored doors for your device, they're also available in the four other standard DotMod colors, which are black, gold, blue, and red. All of them look fantastic. It just depends on your personal taste on what you'd mix with this. Personally, I think the black and the gold look absolutely fantastic on this. The light blue and the gold look wonderful, and the light blue and the black would look great also, I think. However, options for you, you can play around with that and see what you like the most. Same goes for the bottle as well. You can buy the bottle in the four different colors too. So you can get a black, blue, red, and gold bottles. They'll all come with the DotMod logo on them. It's quite hard to see on the camera because it's sort of raised up. You can sort of see it there a little bit. All the different color bottles will come with that. Threaded top cap on here, so you can open it very easily. Fill up your liquid with a nice wide fill hole. Pop that back in and tighten that up. Also, silicone bottle, so very, very nice and easy to squeeze. A little battery adapter. So the device is cut out for a 2700 battery naturally. However, this little plastic adapter tube, you can put in an 18650, and this will make up the extra ground and make it fit like a 2700. I think that's a really great idea because a lot of people have an 18650 battery knocking around at home, whereas not many people would have a 2700 unless they have a device that already uses them, which, as good as the batteries are, they're still relatively new to the market, so they've not really taken over fully yet, the same way that 18650s have. You also get this little bag with two O-rings, which I think is a great idea. I'll show you what these are for now. So these little O-rings will slot right on top of the 510 connection here, which may seem a little bit random. However, I think the purpose is really great. What it does is it creates a little barrier between the device itself and the bottom of your RDA. So it will stop your RDA scuffing the top of the finish. So keep your device looking really fresh, really brand new, rather than having that little scuff mark around the top, which I know I've got on some of mine, and it really kills me. Especially when you buy a device that looks as good as these do, you really want to keep it in top condition and looking perfect and pristine for as long as you can. So I think that's great that they include two of those for you as well. So, put the device back together. You would have your battery in here. That will go in here. Put the doors back on as well. So that door is just there for basically decoration. Pop that one back in. Put your battery in. To reinstall your bottle, you can see the little tube that hangs down, which is the other end of the squonk hole. Straw will just slide on. Slide it onto there, push it up, get your bottle nestled in there nice and perfectly. And your door, make sure you put the hole at the right end. And that goes in there. Another quick thing that I want to highlight, which I'm a big fan of, is inside the door with the hole on it. They've actually sort of cut out a little bit for the battery, which has actually cut down on it and made the device less square, which I am a big, big, big fan of. It just feels really comfortable in the hand because of the slightly pillowed sort of shape. Magnets snap into place really, really nicely. So when it's in the hand, it just feels really nice and rounded. There's no sort of sharp edges again. And as I mentioned probably twice or three times in this video, DotMod have some of the highest manufacturing quality that I've come across in absolutely ages. Everything is finished absolutely flawlessly. We never have any damaged products arriving, and the feel of them is definitely worth the price. As well as the performance, the finish and the look and feel of this device, it truly is a really high-end piece. I'm a huge, huge advocate of everything DotMod are doing. I think they're wonderful. So now we'll show you the squonking in action, so you can see how it actually works. So see with the little bottle here, little hole, so you press in on that, and then there is a little hole directly underneath the coil. Try if I angle that. You can see the little hole just beneath the coil between the airflow. So when you squeeze the bottle, juice will come up through that hole and saturate your wicks, which if I keep the device at this angle, see the juice comes up. Soaks up into your wicks, and when you release the bottle, it will suck the juice back down. So basically, rather than having to take out a bottle of liquid and re-drip your cotton for an RDA, you just squeeze the little bottle, soaks up into the wicks, sucks any excess juice back down, and then you just would have your top cap ready to go and crack on. Tastes good.
Real good.
So a few other little quick features that I want to highlight about this, which I really, really like, is that inside the door where the hole is and your battery goes, they've actually put a little cutout for the battery. So that's cut down a little bit of the size and squareness of it. As you can see, it's a little bit of a beveled sort of thing. So it's a little bit arced. So when you have it in the hand, it just feels really nice. It's almost that like soap bar sort of feel where it's a rectangle, but very, very rounded. So when it's in your hand, it just feels really comfortable and it's meant to be there sort of thing. Really like that. All the magnets are super snappy, which I'm a big, big fan of also. As well as that, the dimensions of the device. So it is 82 millimeters top to bottom. It is 26 millimeters side to side at the thickest point, which is roughly in the center here. At the top, it is 23.5 millimeters. So a 24 millimeter atomizer may hang over the edge, but because of the beveled sort of shape, the soap bar sort of shape, as I'll call it, it sits on there perfectly fine. You would think it would overhang, but it won't. I'm going through these. I know a lot of people that use RDAs and mechanical mods specifically like everything to fit nice and flush. I've seen 24 millimeter atomizers on top of this, which this actually is, and as you can see, there is no noticeable overhang on there whatsoever because of the slight pillowing shape. Quickly as well, the dimensions of the device. I know a lot of people that use RDAs and mechanical mods like everything to fit nice and flush and perfect. So it is 82 millimeters from top to bottom this way. It is 48.5 millimeters across from the thickest points here and here, which would be in the center. And it is 26 millimeters wide at the thickest point here. So around in the center here, it is 23.5 millimeters across on the flat edge. However, due to the pillowing, a 24 millimeter atomizer would look absolutely perfect on there. There'd be no issues of overhang, as you can see here. So that is a 24 millimeter atomizer on there, and you can see that it fits wonderfully due to the slight pillowing. Overall, I feel DotMod have absolutely smashed it out of the park with this little device. I'm a massive, massive fan of it. Also, the limited Tiffany colorway looks absolutely stunning. I'm a massive, massive fan of this sort of color anyway. I like those light pastel shades. Also a color that men and women can both really enjoy. They've not gone to go for a too sort of typically masculine sort of thing or a feminine thing. I think it's absolutely stunning. The gold accents just top it off on there. And all of the replacement doors will also have the gold accent. So if that's something that's really drawing you to it and you don't get the chance to get one of the limited colorways, the black, red, blue, and gold will all have the same gold accents. So let's dive back up. I'll give you the pros and cons and we'll see what I think about the device further. We've had a look at the device up close, spoken very briefly about it. So as always, time for the pros and cons. First pro being, again, with all the DotMod stuff, the build quality, the fit and finish is absolutely flawless. Everything fits together perfectly. No scratches, no scuffs, no blemishes from the factory. Nothing jiggles around, you can hear. Absolutely perfect. Bottle really nice and easy to use. Very easy to fill also. So you just literally pop the back off. I've got no battery in there at the moment. Just pull the little bottle out. Untwist the cap, fill your bottle, and then push it back in. So very, very simple and easy way of filling. As well as if you also are using it with their DotMod.RDA. You can actually fill it through the squonk hole in the RDA. It's from the top, you just put the unicorn bottle in and squeeze it and that'll fill the bottle for you, which is fantastic. 12 milliliter bottle as well is an absolutely massive pro. You can literally, well, for us TPD guys in the UK and Europe, we just put a whole bottle of juice in there and there's still actually room for more. So just put your whole bottle in, squonk until it's finished, and that'll be a whole bottle of juice. Again, uniform with all the DotMod stuff, 24 karat gold plating on the 510 connection and the fire button, which is fantastic. Squonk pin is actually brass and removable, so if you did have any issues, it's removable. You take it out to clean the contacts thoroughly. Absolutely fantastic. Only con I found with the device is the fact that it's mechanical. I always like regulated devices, just to be sure. I do use a mech mod very occasionally, but pretty much all the time I'm using a regulated device so I can up or down the power depending on how I'm feeling. Also, you have to really know what you're doing. This isn't a device you can just pick up, chuck any tank on top of it, fire away, and you're ready to go. You need to sort of know what you're doing when you're building, knowing the amp limits of your batteries, using the correct batteries inside, which we will probably do a video on in the future at some point, so stay tuned for that. So safety would be the paramount thing, knowing battery safety, Ohm's law, what sort of build to put on top of it, and all those sorts of things. Overall, absolutely beautiful device, especially in this limited Tiffany colorway, which we have got. And as always, if you are interested, pop in store, look online. If you want to have a look at this device a little bit closer, we have high resolution images on the website, as well as the actual device itself in store, if you wanted to hold it in hand and feel how it is. Thank you guys for watching, take care of yourselves, and we'll see you very soon.
Do this video or...
Sorry, bro, I was trying to do some science. Like, I'm trying to do science out here, bro. Sorry. Hey, I'm Jack. Oh, not gone off to a good start. I'm Jack. Out the box. No issues. No itches. It might be itchy. It needs some, need some E45 in here, bro.
No itching guaranteed.
No itch guaranteed. Like, oh, Jesus. Is there mechanical. Dot mod, which is there.